Om Sri Sai Ram. Prasanthi Sandesh, Sunday Post Podcast. Once it so happened, a big man, by virtue of his position and devotion, came towards me and said, "Anil Kumar, be careful. Don't take things for granted. Staying with Swami is something like walking on razor's edge. You should walk through the fire and see that you are not burned. It is a challenging thing. You must be highly careful." These are the words from a very elderly gentleman, highly experienced devotee and an able administrator of the whole of Brindavan, today called Trayee Brindavan, there in Whitefield at Bangalore. This gentleman's name is Sri Rama Brahmam. Rama Brahmam served as the caretaker of Brindavan until his last breath. When he took over charge, when Swami asked him to be there as the caretaker, it was almost a forest. There were no lights also. And snakes often make their appearance. He used to carry the torch with him and move around. That was the condition then. Today, it has become the heart of the city. Conditions then were totally different. And there were no buildings around excepting Swami's place, residence, that's all. And this Ram Brahmam is known to me since long. And Swami wanted me to take charge as the principal of Sri Sai Institute of Higher Learning at Bangalore in the year 1989. I know Ram Brahmam very well, and he is a resident of Brindavan campus. I was staying next to his building there in the bungalow allotted to me. I used to visit him every day and seek his guidance, and noted every point he said. And today I believe I could have successful tenure of office there in 6 years. It is purely because of the guidance of Sri Rama Brahmam. Of course, the divine inscrutable will is there. But this gentleman served as a powerful instrument in the hands of Swami by advising me from time to time. One day, Rama Brahmam said, "Mr. Anil Kumar, there may be a situation when you may be asked to get out of Brindavan. Swami is a perfectionist. He will not tolerate any simple mistake. The punishment is total. He will ask you to quit your bungalow and get out." And then I said, "Sir, is it so? Is he so harsh? Then what do you want me to do when he asks me to get out?" And Rama Brahmam said, "You come out of your bungalow, but don't leave Bangalore. You sit at the gate. Sit down. Wait until Swami calls you back. He is full of kindness, full of mercy. Our dear God cannot bear the suffering of anybody. He asks you to get out and He wants you to obey His command. But watching you, waiting for Him, His heart melts and immediately calls you and permits you to go back to your residence. This is one thing that Sri Ram Brahmam told me. And the second point he said was, when he scolds you, don't look that way and this way. Just look straight, right, straight onto his face and pray for his mercy. Swami, pardon me if I have committed any mistake. Please be kind to me. That's how you should pray. But if you look that side and this side, well, it only means Swami will certainly take it that you are a man of ego. Out of ego, you want to see people, how they react when Swami is scolding you, that he doesn't like. Simply pray to him. That is the second caution he told me. And third thing he told me was, when he says anything, do it implicitly, immediately. Don't delay. And give me his own example. It seems Swami wanted him to come to his room one day in Vrindavan. This gentleman, Ramabrahmam, was holding flask in his hands, Dharma's flask. So he kept it aside in a separate room and reported to Swami. Swami, you called me? Swami said, not now. I called you then. You should have come immediately. But you have taken time to keep the flask in a separate room and took time to come to me. No, no, I call you then, not now. This Ramabrahmam told me and said, when Swami says anything, you should do it immediately. You should not take time. You should never delay. And Swami will be very much upset with you. And narrated his experience. In Vrindavan, they were getting ready to have a bore well there for water. Several were working there with their crowbars, trying to dig the ground. But they could not get water. But that way, Ramabrahmam happened to pass by that. The several people requested him, sir, sir, would you come and help us? So Ramabrahmam, elderly man, went there, took the crowbar and hit the ground. No water. Instead, he fell on the ground. Ramabrahmam always wears white dress, pure white dress, as white as anything else, oh, pure white. Because with this man, this Ramabrahmam fell down, the whole of his dhoti and shirt got completely spoiled, full of this mud and slush. Because he fell down on the ground, what to do? Then it was time for him to go to Vrindavan and report to Swami. Then he went there. And then Swami called him. What he did was, he changed his dress and reported to Swami. Swami, you called me? Do you know what Swami said, Ramabrahmam? Had I not been there when you fell down, you would have got your hip bone completely fractured and you would have suffered like anything. I was there at that time and saved you. When I come to the rescue of my devotees immediately, and you people take your own time to report to me when I want you, when I call you. This Ramabrahmam told me. So, just as Swami responds to our prayers, immediately we need to attend to his command, to the duties assigned to us, as in when they are commanded or given to us. This is the lesson that Sri Ramabrahmam told me. And once he also, mentioning his experience, Swami, it seems, gave him his dress. You know, Swami is so thin, 5 feet 3 inches, very lean, very thin. He gave his dress to Ramabrahmam to wear. Ramabrahmam is tall, well-built, hefty personality. How can he wear his dress? Swami's dress may not fit. His hand also won't go in, because he's such a well-built man. But Swami insisted, you wear this dress. So he started wearing. by the time he was trying to wear, he was feeling breathless. Because the shirt was so tight, because Swami was so thin. He was saying, "Swami, Swami, I'm breathless, breathless. Hey, come on, wear." RAMABRAHMAM told me, "Anil Kumar, as I was wearing, believe me or not, all that angi, the dress of Swami that I wore, started increasing its size on its own. Gradually, slowly, it was increasing. And at the end, it was a perfect fit to me," he said. And he said, "Never it happens. Never it happened. How is it a garment stitched to grow as you are wearing, as you put on? Do you find any garment growing in its size?" That had happened. That's what RAMABRAHMAM told me as one of his experiences. And later he also narrated another incident in his life. To the extent I remember, he has 3 sons and 2 daughters, I believe. And Swami once called him and said, "RAMABRAHMAM, you and your wife go to your place immediately." And called RAMABRAHMAM aside and told him, "You lost your 2nd son. Don't tell your wife until you go there. Come on, both of you go. It takes about 19 hours to reach his place." Swallowing all the misery, all the pain within himself, he was crying within and went along with his wife to his native place. By the time he reached there, the body was there and all relatives around. Both of them cried bitterly and somehow attended all the riots they are supposed to do. And then both of them returned back to Brindavan. Seeing Swami, his wife wept bitterly. "Swami, you have taken away my son, which we never expected, Swami. How unfortunate we are. How unkind you are, Swami. What happened to my son?" Because she is the mother of a grown-up son, naturally. And Swami said, "Don't worry. He is with me." And RAMABRAHMAM's wife said, "Don't say that, Swami. How can he be with you? No, no, no. We have lost him. Why do you say that?" And then Swami said, "Don't cry. You both go into the interview room," Swami said. Both of them went into the interview room. There they saw their son. They were stunned to see him. They spoke to him for a brief time and came out of the room, and that boy disappeared from there, vanished from there. This is personal experience of Sri Rama Brahmam. It is said in Bhagavad Gita and Upanishads, we are all from God, in God, and we'll be back to God. So when Swami said, "He is with me," it only means what? He has gone back to the source. This is the experience that RAMABRAHMAM narrated me. These narrations I can never forget in life, because they helped me to continue to stay there. There are something like precautions. There are something like certain important principles to be observed that helped me. Incidentally, I may mention to you that Sri RAMABRAHMAM is a very big businessman. Earlier, before coming to Brindavan, big tobacco merchant, he earned crores of money. To put in his own words, "I didn't have time even to count the currency I earned in those days." But it so happened that he lost all his properties, and both husband and wife came to Brindavan. It was at that time Swami made him the caretaker of the whole Brindavan, and wanted them to stay in one of the residences specially provided for them. And he stayed there till the last moment of his life. RAMABRAHMAM was such a sincere man, a man of devotion. And I said, "Sir, you said Swami will be upset with you and he may ask you to get out and all that. Would you tell me some details?" And RAMABRAHMAM said, "Anil Kumar, there are two gates you will observe to Brindavan. One near the railway gate, another other side. Swami asked me to get out and I came out of this gate. Still I didn't experience that gate. I was kicked out 10 times. But I was wondering, why should you be kicked out? Swami, what is the reason, sir? Why did Swami ask you to go?" And RAMABRAHMAM said, "Yes, Anil Kumar, I never committed any mistake. Because I was defending all the boys staying in the hostel. Poor boys, they have come all the way to study. And their parents have sent them this long. So when Swami asked, is this a good boy? Very good boy, Swami." Swami said, "You are bluffing. That boy is stupid. First you get out." So I faced all punishments because I was defending the boys there. I didn't commit any mistake at any point of time. That's what RAMABRAHMAM said. That was his kindness. That was kindness. He also narrated me another very funny incident. Isil Swami asked RAMABRAHMAM, "You go and tell in the shed that there is no darshan this morning." So RAMABRAHMAM came out and announced devotees that there is no darshan. Walking behind him, immediately Swami came there, slowly walking behind him, laughing loudly, showing some signs that RAMABRAHMAM has gone mad, and he gave darshan. At that time I asked RAMABRAHMAM, "Sir, when he asked you that there is no darshan today and he gave darshan, are you not upset with this? Don't you look like a fool to everybody?" Then RAMABRAHMAM said, "We should not think like that. Remember that we are instruments in his hands, that we are privileged and blessed to be a participant, an actor in this divine drama. That I could be an instrument to provide enough of fun, humor to my Lord, that I am very happy. So feel happy, that's all. Because you are given a role to play. And you made Swami laugh. What more you want?" That's what RAMABRAHMAM said. That's still ringing in my ears. Therefore, these are the guidelines given to me by him. And one thing I'll tell you. Once he said, "Anil Kumar, I saw you joking with Swami, laughing with him. But remember always that he is God. Don't take things for granted. Suppose in my case, I look at him as Lord Shiva, with three horizontal stripes on the forehead as Lord Shiva. So keep in mind that he is God and then behave." That's what he said. These things I want to share with you as slowly, week after week, God willing. Sai Ram.